Morning students, now we will continue the study of linear inequality with exercise 6.1. Yesterday we finished examples and it is exercise 6.1. We have a few questions which is important to tell you. So I'm telling you, we have a few long questions also, but don't worry about the concept is very easy. So let me pick some questions from the exercise. Suppose I'm telling you here the 16th one. 2x minus 1 upon 3 greater than or equal to 3x minus 2 upon 4 minus 2 minus x upon 5. And you are told to solve. So very easy it is. You do only as you work as a equal to sign. It is a only inequality sign. So first, you take an LCM of these two, it's a 20. So 5 will multiply here, 15 minus 10, 4 will multiply here, 8 minus 4x, 2x minus 1 upon 3, 15x minus 10 minus 8 plus 4x upon 20, 2x minus 1 upon 3, these two will be 19x and this is a 18 upon 20. Now do the cross multiply again, it gonna be like that and it is this one. Now definitely we have a 57 is a larger than 40, so it's well to transfer the term of x this side. So minus 20 plus 54 and 57x minus 40x both will be 34 and these two will be 17x. So again I want to write the same term. First I want to write 17x less than 34 and then find your x 34 upon 17, which means 2, and this is your answer. If you want to represent on the number line, you write only 2. This is infinite, this is infinite. So x is equal to 2 as well as x less than 2. So your answer is minus infinite to 2, close bracket. It's very easy, it is nothing hard. It seems tough, but it is not so. So I don't think that I need to tell you once again all the things. Now we have a same question, all are same question, so I don't want to tell you more and more about that. From 17 to 20 we have a same question, but we have to represent an answer in the on the graph, meaning on the number line, as I did here. So it's all same. 20, let me speak something. Question 21, 22, 23, 24. In examples, I did both kind of question. 21, 22, the same kind of questions I taught in from the examples, average marks. And 23, 24 is a consecutive odd number and consecutive even number question type here. So I think all four questions are based on the example side. 25th and 26th, I want to tell you from my side only. So look at 25th question. The longest side of the triangle is 3 times the shortest side and the third side is 2 cm shorter than the longest side. If the parameter of the triangle is at least 61 cm, find the minimum length of the shortest side. It is asking, so we definitely let the shortest side of the triangle be x. We have definitely 3 sides in a triangle. So suppose shortest side be x. Now read the question. The longest side of the triangle, as per question, the longest side of the triangle is 3 times the shortest side, meaning it is a 3x. Suppose it is the longest side. And the other side meaning this side, which is third side is 2 cm shorter than the longest side. Longest side is 3x and 2 shorter, meaning 3x minus 2. So all about that, these are 3 sides now we have. And according to question, what says it is? The parameter of the triangle, you know it's a parameter of the triangle, is at least 61, and I taught you the symbol of at least. Whenever at least is coming, meaning it is either equal to 61 or more than 61. So at least 61 it is called.
And what is the parameter of the triangle? Some false sides. You know that some false sides is the parameter of triangle. Parameter of triangle is this one. So in our knowledge, parameter meaning some false sides x plus 3x plus 3x minus 2. Now you can find your x. 3 and 3 is 7x. 2 will transfer. That's a 61 plus 2 is 63. So your answer is 63 upon 7. So your answer is 9. So whole meaning is x greater than or equal to 9. Greater than or equal to 9, like that. Either equal to 9 or greater than 9. So what we are asked here? The minimum length of the shortest side. So tell me, what is the minimum length? Minimum length meaning here of the shortest side. Of the shortest side. So I tell you one thing, that shortest side assumed x. And what is the minimum value of x? Definitely it is 9. Because all the value are greater than 9. So least value is a 9. So you know the answer is only x equal to 9. So x was assumed as the shortest side. And we have to tell here what is the minimum value of the shortest side. Meaning minimum value of x. So minimum value of x is 9. And the other values of x is definitely greater than 9. So this is a simple you know that word problem. You just have to understand about the word problem, make the inequality and solve your problem. Now we have a 26th question, which is a definite, I will tell you. A man wants to cut 3 lengths from a single piece of a board of length 91 cm. Suppose this is a 91 cm board and a man wants to cut 3 pieces from these. So one can think that, what about the 3 pieces? Meaning, if he or she cuts one piece, second piece and third piece, what do you think? The sum of the 3 pieces may equal to 91, may be equal to 91 or less than 91. Definitely it's a final length of the board, 91 centimeter. And a person wants to cut 3 pieces from 91. It may be like, suppose a person is cutting first this piece, second this piece, third this piece. What do you think? Sum of the 3 pieces, again less than 91. Or if a person is cutting first piece, second piece and third piece. It means the sum of the 3 pieces is equal to 91. I just want to speak that when you will cut or when person cuts 3 pieces, some of the pieces definitely will be either equal to 91 or less than 91, because 91 is a final length of the board. So definitely length of the pieces will not exceed or more than 91. It is either equal to 91 or less than 91. That's very important thing which I told you. If you couldn't understand, please try to hear this sentences two or three times by repeating your video. I think you will get it. So okay, let me speak something. So what question says? The second length, a man wants to cut 3 lengths from a single piece of the board of length 91 cm. The second length is to be 3 cm longer than the shortest one. And third length is to be twice as long as the shortest one. Both depend on shortest one. So let the length of the shortest piece be x. So as per question, the second length is 3 cm longer than the shortest one, and the third length will be twice as long as the shortest one. Now we have got a 3 distances. Again, read the question properly. First thing which I want to share with you without reading this, that if first piece is x, second piece is x plus 3 and third piece is 2x, so definitely some of the pieces will be, without reading the question, some of pieces will be either equal to 91 or less than 91. Recently I taught you without reading the question, because it is very genuine and it is very simple, and you know that one can understand it very easily, because the three pieces we have, which is cut from the length of 91 centimeter board, when you will add all the lengths, it will definitely equal to 91 or less than 91. Because someone is cutting first piece x, second piece x plus 3 and third piece 2x. What do you think about that? When you will add them, it is definitely less than 91. Or some is cutting this like first is x, second is x plus 3 and this is a supposed 2x. What do you think about that? And sum of all pieces equal to 91. So, I don't think that's tough for you. Understandable it is. So, sum of pieces meaning x plus 3 plus 2x gonna be 91. X, 2x, 3x is a 4x plus 3. 3 will transfer that side only. It's gonna be 88. So your answer is 22. It's not an answer, but it is a first condition. From the first condition, I got value of x, the limitation of x, but we yet to read the next condition. What are the possible length of the shortest? What are the possible lengths? What are the possible lengths? Meaning x may be more than one value. So x can attain more than one value. Like what? According to the question or next condition, it says if the third piece, what question says? If the third piece is to be at least 5 centimeters, at least meaning this symbol, at least 5 centimeters longer than the second one. Try to understand the word. You just have to follow the terminology. The third piece is at least, I taught you the symbol of at least, 5 centimeters longer, meaning 5 plus with the second piece. So we have written as it is and we used to write an equation. So this is inequality where at least word is coming. So we follow only. What is the third piece? Look at student, third piece is 2x. It is symbol of at least. Second piece is x plus 3. And this is 5. So we got a transfer to x here. 2x minus x is x. And it is 8 by 3, 8. Now can you combine 1 and 2? Can you join 1 and 2? This is x less than 22. This is x greater than 8. So write from 8. 8 less than x. And x is here. We need not try it again. X less than 22. So this is a possible length. You got an answer. You got an answer. Meaning, what are the possible lengths of shortest side? What is shortest side? It is. It was x. Shortest piece. The length of the. And you know the length of the shortest piece was x. And we have got the range of the x. From 88, from 8 to 22. Now this is the answer which were asked here. Which were asked here that what are the possible lengths of the third shortest piece, which is from 8 to 22. And this is the answer. So hope you got here. So this is the exercise from my side only. The questions are so easy. If you feel any trouble or difficulties, you are free to ask me. Please feel free to ask me and ask me your doubts, and you can send your problems on WhatsApp. You will definitely get your solution instantly. So please don't hesitate for that. Okay. So this is the first exercise. Now I'm moving on to the second exercise. So let me speak something. We are studying in the graphical representation, the solution of a graphical solution. What is its meaning? It's easy. So let me start with the beginning. If I ask you, that what is the solution? What is the solution? If I ask you, what is the meaning of x equal to 0? It's very interesting, no? X is equal to 0. So one cannot understand, but as you are growing in the, as you're growing up, definitely going in a, studying in a big classes, a high classes, so you should understand that what is the meaning of x equal to 0. I tell you one thing, that it is x. So let me speak freely that a meaning of x equal to 0, meaning it is a y-axis. One should understand it is a y-axis, and one should know that on the y-axis, everywhere y is equal to, x equal to 0. So this is none else but it is an equation of y-axis, and whenever only this portion is coming, it means you are talking about the y-axis. Okay. Now if I write, instead of that, I write x greater than or equal to 0. If I am writing this, so what is its meaning? So one can simply understand x greater than or equal to 0. It means x is equal to 0 or x greater than 0. Just write x equal to 0 or x greater than 0. Both follows. What is the meaning of x equal to 0?
I taught you it is none else but it is itself y-axis. Itself y-axis x equal to 0. And what is x greater than 0?
I tell you x greater than 0 meaning this point, this all are x greater than 0. Meaning in first quadrant and in the fourth quadrant, everywhere x greater than 0. You will go here, definitely point x greater than 0. If you point here, it's definitely it's a greater than 0. I tell you frankly that from the region this particular, which I'm sharing here for you guys, this is none else, but it is x greater than 0, x greater than 0. So along with the y-axis, look at I made it dark, and along with the y-axis, this shaded region all represent none else but x greater than or equal to 0. This is the graphical solution. If this is coming in front of you and you are told to represent your solution in the graph, you just have to make the axis and represent your solution like that. But you know, it depends on the base. You should know that it is actually x greater than or equal to 0. First, how you can think that work? First, you go through x is equal to 0. You go for x equal to 0. Now you will get a baseline. Baseline meaning you just have come to know this time that this is a particular line, and with the help of this line, we can represent the solution. X equal to 0 meaning which axis?
Y axis.
Now go on for this. Now it is saying x greater than 0. And equal to 0 already taught you what's a y axis. So this is a y-axis, and x greater than 0 meaning moving this side. Okay, if I ask you instantly like that, represent that on the graph, what do you write? You will simply make a axis. X, first think this is none else, it is a y-axis. Meaning we will take the help of this y-axis. We'll take the help of y-axis, and it is x less than 0. So where is x less than 0? Definitely here. This is a region where x is less than 0. So you will make a shaded region. Now this time I made the shaded region with the long lines. But I tell you that this is not a good way to representation. A good way is like that. You have to draw very small lines, very simple shade. Because if you draw the long, you know that lines, it will not seem good. So it looks good now. You just make a shorter line like that. And it is simply showing that it is x less than or equal to 0. So hope you have till now understood. If I ask you one thing, that represent x less than or equal to y less than, like this. Sorry, x greater than and y. Meaning in a single graph you have to represent both. In a single graph you have to represent both. So what you will do? X, y, x dash, y dash. X greater than or equal to 0, meaning I recently taught you that it will with the help of y axis, and x equal to 0, y axis, x greater than 0, meaning this region. And what about that y? Now let me speak frankly. Y equal to 0 meaning x axis, and y greater than 0 meaning y, where the y greater than 0? In this region and this. In these two quadrants, definitely y is positive, because this is a y positive line and this is a negative y. So when a positive y will follow y greater than 0, meaning in these two regions, I'll follow like that. Here the y greater than 0 along with the x axis y equal to 0. Let me speak. Y equal to 0 meaning x axis, and y greater than 0 meaning upside. X equal to 0 meaning y axis, and x greater than meaning here. And when you will draw both on a single graph, now we have to give the combined answer. And what is a combined meaning? Common answer. So student, common answer is definitely this region. This is a first quadrant. So this will be your reply. This will be your answer. So you know, common region will be your answer. If instead of these we have a three inequalities, definitely we have to draw all the three on a single graph, and definitely we have to see that which one is a common region, common area. So that will be the answer. So hope you have got till now here. This is a very beginning, but one by one you can understand. Now let me speak something more about that. x is equal to constant coming. If this is coming like that, if I ask you the question x greater than 2, very good, where it is. Actually, I taught you recently it is a 0, x greater than 0, x less than 0, y greater than 0, y less than 0. Now, you now knowing now all about that. Now, it's very first time, some strange I changed here, it is 2. So how to begin this question? Let me speak that first you think x equal to 2. So whenever any inequality is coming in front of you to shed or to draw on the graph, you first take equal to condition. This will give you baseline. What is x equal to 2? One can simply understand. And if you have forgot, I tell you that x equal to 2, but it is none else, but it is a line parallel to y-axis. You are in 11th class now, students. You have to keep remember, because this is an important part of the geometry also, which is, you know, that in your syllabus also, straight line section. So, in you have to understand x equal to constant. Whenever x equal to constant coming, you have to understand about this. What is this? This is the equation of the line parallel to y-axis. Look at it. This is a y-axis. And parallel to y-axis, you can draw here, you can draw here, but it is very simple mentioned here, x equal to 2. So, it is x equal to 1, it is x equal to 2. So, your line will definitely pass from x equal to 2 and x equal to 2, which is parallel to the y-axis. So, this is the equation of this line. And what it is asking about? It is x equal to 2 as well as x greater than 2. So tell me, x equal to 2 you have drawn and x greater than 2. It is definitely right side. X greater than 2, 2, 3, 4. Definitely you have to shed the region along with this line like that. Because in both the region where this line will go up, it will follow this condition. X equal to 2 is a line and x greater than 2 meaning all the region right side of this. If it is coming x less than 2, definitely same figure will be there, but shading will be left side. That's simple. If it is coming, suppose y greater than 2 coming, then what you will do? Nothing. It is x dash, y dash. What you will do? Suppose less than coming. Like that. So what you will write? First take y is equal to 2. So what is the meaning of y equal to 2? So please give a similar answer. Line parallel to x-axis, because it is y equal to. So line parallel to x-axis meaning either it will be like that or like that. So it is depending y equal to 2 meaning y equal to 1, y equal to 2. Your line is like that. It is y equal to 2. Now y less than 2. Less than 2. So where is the less than 2? Definitely less than meaning y less than 2 meaning this is the region. Downside. And y greater than 2 meaning upside. So definitely your answer is like that. This region where the line can be drawn or line goes, whole region will be called y less than or equal to. So hope student you have now come to know the meaning of all. Now in difficult in two variable inequalities region, I will tell you tomorrow. So please study here till here and do 6.1 exercise also. Thank you.